Hi, I'm Dragan Ristic, Manager of Process Engineering at Regis Technologies. I have been working in pharma industry for over 35 years in different engineering and scientific roles. My official training is in chemical engineering. Today we're going to talk about WetMill micronization of APIs and about its advantages over dry milling. Regis Technologies is a CDMO providing full service in a small molecular API development and manufacturing. We perform a phase appropriate process development and manufacturing of APIs. Micronization or particle size reduction is one of the key processes in the drug development. It is typically the final operation performed before an API is sent for the drug formulation. It is possible to use two basic methods of the process of the particle size reduction, dry milling and wet milling. The method selection actually depends on the desired API attributes for the formulation. Wet milling is the preferred micronization solution at Regis, and we will explain why in the following slides. Traditional jet milling has been used in industry for a while, but recently has been reevaluated because of the yield losses and problems that could be associated with the containment, and also that negative impact on physical properties of APIs. Wet milling offers solutions to many of the challenges associated with dry milling. The quadro wet mill and emulsifier that we have at Regis is producing a smaller particles than conventional wet mills, in the range of 10 to 20 microns, which is pretty close to the jet mill performance. Our wet mill unit has been built with materials that comply with FDA regulations and also with GMP standards. All the product contact parts are made from Hastell OEC 276. The wet mill system is installed in the skid, on the skid with casters, and it could be moved to the reactor suites based on the need. Next slide. This drawing describes our preferred configuration of wet milling. The system is designed to reduce particle size of the product in a slurry or suspension, which is steered in the reactor on the left. The reactor is connected to the temperature control unit, which provides cooling or the heat removal. From the bottom valve, the slurry is transferred by supply pump into the wet mill. As the slurry passes through the unit, it is exposed to the high velocity rotor stator action and then forced out. The slurry is then recycled back to the top of the reactor. The milling cycles are continued until desired number of batch turnovers are achieved, or until there is no more significant change in the particle size distribution. Next slide, please. Now we're going to talk about factors for particle size reduction in wet milling. Most wet mill studies confirm importance of maintaining a constant tip speed of the rotor across the scales to achieve desired particle size as a function of batch turnovers. By increasing the rotor tip speed to 70 meters per second, the particle sizes in the range of 10 to 20 microns are achievable. Flow rate, starting particle size, and slurry concentration may also impact the mill performance, but their effects are not as significant as the number of batch turnovers or tip speed of the rotor. The important factor for scaling up of milling kinetics is maintaining the geometric consistency across the different batch sizes. Next slide, please. Here we can summarize advantages of wet mill micronization versus jet milling. There is a little or no yield loss in wet milling during wet milling. The quadro wet mill is portable, and the same unit could be used for the lab scale process development and for the GMP manufacturing. During the jet mill process, a large quantity of energy is used, and that may lead to undesired morphologic changes. Wet mill is the ideal choice for sensitive materials because liquid dissipates heat generated. There is a little chance for polymorphic form change. Wet mill provides higher level of control of particle size distribution and physical properties of APIs. And wet mill also improves the batch homogeneity and batch-to-batch consistency. There are significant safety and containment benefits of wet milling. Wet mill avoids high energy operations. It protects the API better by minimizing exposure to environment. And also it manages occupational exposure to worker more efficiently and without any additional containment. Now we can, on this slide, summarize wet mill micronization at Regis. Our wet mill unit can be run in pilot mode for a lab scale process development and in production mode for GMP manufacturing in the range from 1 kilogram to 100 kilograms per batch. Regis micronization and solid-state chemistry services are offered in support of our manufacturing and also as standalone services. On the last two slides, we have photos of our production engineers preparing the wet mill for process development experiments on pilot scale. So on the first photo, there is setting up of the wet mill. And on the second photo, control panel and startup check. And that would bring us to the end of this presentation. Thank you so much for your interest and for attention.